And welcome back, guys. We're going to be playing some more Starfield. Currently, I'm looking for a planet that has benzene, because I have a quest to fill an order of 500 benzene. Or a planet that looks like it has plenty of iron and, you know, good stuff that's worth landing on and building an outpost on. I have a skill that I have to level up by building on three planets, so I figured, you know, why not? I have to check out some solar systems, show me doing that, and showing me trying to find a place to build a decent outpost on. I thought you guys might be interested in that, so here we are. And some of you guys like me building outposts. I'm like, alright, okay, why not? Anyways, make sure to like button, make sure to subscribe button. Let's get into it.
There may not be life here, but we should still be cautious.
All clear. And land this ship.
Thank you. conditions for construction. Destruction is much easier and often more fun. normal gravity that anything lower feels almost comical. might wish to lighten your load. One is less likely to survive an ambush when one is weighed down with whatever all that is. I do not wish to judge. but I doubt you.
You are entering United Colony space. Please maintain course and prepare to be scanned. And we're done. Enjoy Gagarin.
Landing gear. Check. Thrusters. Check. Ignite. Clear.
So since the update for Starfield here, see how it's no longer a circle? Yeah, they made the bug worse. It's quite annoying. Because there's half my circle is missing of what I could use. I can't use any of this because the game won't read it. So I'm stuck with this little circle over here, or a square. It's like, really? Fix your damn game. You release something for $100... and you haven't fixed the basic things that are pissing people off. What am I doing right now? I am building little mini outposts over the place. This way, I can level up that right there. Yeah, that's what I'm doing. And it worked, didn't it? I'm just gonna find my thingy and remove the outpost. Okay, you out of the way. Let's remove it. Now I just gotta level up, and I gotta level up this. Then I can have 8 outposts. Then when I level this one up, I can have 12. And then when I get this one, I can have 16 outposts. That's a good thing. Then I'll start working on this stuff. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to do an inventory check on my primary outpost, my primary base, see what I need. I know I need beryllium. So I'm going to go travel to the planet that, well, first, let me actually go there and offload everything I have. And I'll kind of show you what I've got set up here. So let me make sure that this is doing what it's supposed to be doing, like, you know, offloading. For some reason, it will only let me offload from here. I wanted to set up on the other planet, but oh well. I'm gonna guess it's gonna be one of those buggy quests. I wish Bethesda would fix the outpost race.
No indigenous life signs. One less thing to worry about, I suppose.
So, usually, I'll have that pad there putting out helium H3, and that's literally what those ships over there, the cargo ships, run off of. It's H3. This is just kind of, these storage units here are kind of just me just throwing the crap in there, and I'll sort it later. Now, over here, this is for like the industrial stuff. This is where, you know, you put in the resources you need. These automatically make it for you. Anyways, I need to go check my iron reserves. Looks like we're doing alright on iron. Looks like we're pretty full here. Alright, let me take a look back here. Like, I need to get some more titanium. It's getting low. What is this? This is nickel. We're finding nickel. Ooh, I don't know what this is, but it's aluminum. That's automatically self-generating. Okay. Don't need to worry about that. I don't know what that is, and it's not good that we're low on it. Cobalt. One, two, three. So it's 5, 1,000, 2,000, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let's see here. So each one of these holds 500 units of material. So 5, 10, which is just 1,000, 2,000, 3, 4. 4,500 cobalt needed to fill these. I know you're just looking at me like, holy shit. Yeah. 4,500 coal. So I'm writing down my notes of what we need. Alrighty. Go over this way. Because these are making magnets, which then I can make comm relays, which I can get XP and sell it off for a decent price. What is this? It looks like we're copper. And now I gotta count how many storage units are low. So, 1,000, 2,000, 4,500 copper. Just to fill those up. All right, let's take a look back here. Looks like we need Tungus. 1,000, 2,000, 5. So we need 2,500 of Tungus. Of that stuff. I'm going to go through and figure out what I need, and then I'm going to offload, and then I'm going to go get it what we need to fill these. I'm gonna guess that this might be... Nope, this is lead. I'm not gonna fill it yet. Ooh, the beryllium's going down quick. Alrighty, I guess we're getting some beryllium while we're out there too. 1,000, 2,000, 3,000, 4,000, 5,000, we'll just call it 6,000 and I'll just store the rest somewhere else. So that's what's going on there, we're getting low on that. I believe these are just usually empty. So one of the lovely things about an automated farm or facility, those right back there are making isomagnets. And then we have two more of those industrial maker thingies. I think they're over here. Yeah. These are making, I think it's a relay of some kind. They're making this thing that you need in order to make the comm relay, which is this. So right now that's stockpiling that, basically. So now I need to go empty my ship before we get back into grabbing more stuff.
Thank you.
Alright, for resources wise, so far in the ship, looks like everything else that's in the cargo hold can be just sold off, basically. So all this can be just basically sold off. I don't need it, except for the helium. I do need that, though.
Thank you.
trying to figure out that damn quest. It doesn't tell you what you need to do. I'm just gonna hook it up and see what happens. That's all you really can do. Ride to this planet here and sell all this crap off in our inventory, and then we get to go and, or at least I get to go and get all the stuff I need to fill up those containers so those can auto build while I'm out doing quests. Ugh, lots of grinding, especially when the game's bugging out, it does not help much.
Please, if you experience any issues in your dealings with... Welcome to UC Distribute. Oh, well... You're always welcome back, if you don't mind a bit of a wait.
No organics here. valuable minerals, perhaps.
Light on our feet. You never know what could happen. where we left it?
Thank you.
on your mind? I have never been. We will speak again. I'm sure. Find Aaron. If I can take a few. Look after yourself. Is there some compulsion that leads you to do this? Childhood trauma? It is okay to let things go.
Thank you.
Alrighty, that looks like a good place to stop. Make sure to like button, make sure to subscribe button. I'm gonna go get some more beryllium and fill off the tanks and top them off the best I can. And when I see you guys in the next video, hopefully we'll be doing some side questing. Yeah, once in a while I've got to refill all these, and you know, then they go back to making stuff. Then I can go make com relays and level up or sell it for money and things like that. I haven't spent all any of my credits. I do plan to buy the most expensive ship in the game, so. Anyways, I'll see you guys next video.